If you are having difficulty becoming pregnant, your fertility specialist will perform several different tests to look for the underlying causes. One of the most important groups of tests is for estimating your ovarian reserve. What is ovarian reserve? How do you test it? What did the results mean? I am fertility expert Dr. Randy Morris, MD, and I have the answers to these and other questions. Stay tuned. Women produce all of the eggs they will ever have in their lifetime before they're born. About 3 months before birth, all egg production stops. The eggs then start a lifelong process of degeneration. Therefore, the older a woman becomes, the less eggs remain in her ovaries. The number of eggs remaining in the ovaries is called ovarian reserve. There are three tests that doctors will use to estimate your ovarian reserve. The first two are blood tests. The most commonly used blood test is called AMH. AMH is a protein produced in the ovaries from the eggs that remain. People with less eggs remaining have lower AMH levels. Older women, therefore, have lower AMH levels on average compared to younger women. But even in a group of women who are the same age, those with less eggs remaining will have lower AMH levels. It turns out that AMH is a pretty good overall marker for fertility. For example, in the largest study to date, women with low AMH levels took about 20% longer to get pregnant on their own compared to women with normal levels. AMH is also a very good predictor for success with IVF. Women with low AMH levels do not respond to IVF medications as well. They produce less eggs and therefore less embryos. As a result, their chance for pregnancy and for having a live born baby is lower. In fact, at any age, the lower your AMH gets, the lower your chances for success. A second blood test for measuring ovarian reserve is called FSH, or follicle stimulating hormone. FSH is produced in the pituitary gland, not the ovaries. In a woman with normal ovarian reserve, FSH levels will be low, the opposite of what we see with AMH. FSH is trickier to measure than AMH. It fluctuates a lot more during the menstrual cycle than AMH does, and it fluctuates more from 1 month to the next compared to AMH. In order to standardize the results, both AMH and FSH are typically tested early in the menstrual cycle, on the second or third day of a period. You do not need to be fasting for these blood tests. The third method for testing ovarian reserve uses ultrasound. When looking at the ovaries, we can see these tiny cysts called follicles. Each follicle contains an egg. By counting the number of follicles that are visible on ultrasound, doctors can get an estimate of ovarian reserve. This is called an antral follicle count. A normal follicle count indicating good ovarian reserve is 10 or more follicles in each ovary. Borderline is between 5 and 10. A low follicle count is less than 5 follicles in each ovary. One important thing to remember about your follicle count: doctors are not counting the exact number of eggs remaining in the ovaries. A follicle count of 5 does not mean that there are only 5 eggs left. Instead, follicle counts are a general guide to the number of eggs remaining. A low follicle count means that there are less eggs remaining. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this: measuring ovarian reserve is a very important test that all women should have at the beginning of their infertility evaluation. It helps to identify one cause for infertility and helps predict the chances for success with some types of fertility treatments, such as IVF. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, ivf1.com, where you can become a patient.